So I'm going to start by working on number 17. What is the formal charge of the nitrogen atom in the Lewis structure for the most significant resonance contributor for the thiocyanate ion? And they give us a hint that there are three resonance structures. So our molecule starts SCN minus, right? So I'm going to spread this out a little. Right, there's now spread out. We know that the total charge on this is 1 minus. The thing is, if you remember your electronegativity trends, N is much smaller than S. So N is going to be the more electronegative element, which means any of the charges that are apparent on this molecule, in this case a 1 minus, they're all going to be localized on this particular system. You also remember that carbon has a maximum of 4 bonds, and that nitrogen can have a maximum of 8 electrons too, either in lone pairs or in bonds. Typically, nitrogen won't have more than 2 lone pairs at any given time. So let's start by drawing the three types of resonance structures. Like that, right? Basically, all three of them are the situation where carbon exists having 4 bonds. So now we've got to make sure that we have enough electrons for each one of these. In this system here, in order for nitrogen to hold the negative charge, it would have to have more than 1 lone pair. It would have to have 2 lone pairs in some way. But in this case, we have more than 8 electrons. You guys remember that in this system here, because when we're calculating our formal charge, it's the number of protons, in this case 5, minus individual bonds as well as individual electrons in lone pairs. So when we're doing our formal charge, this is 5 minus 5 equals 0, right? And there's no way we can increase our number of electrons without increasing the amount of electrons that are present. So this one, no matter what we do, we don't even have to continue working on this anymore because we can't put a negative charge on here, and it's not going to exist on these. So this one's obviously wrong. Okay? So now we've got these two here. We could put electrons like this for nitrogen, which would give this 5 minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, a negative 2 formal charge. And then the sulfur over here would have, it has 6 valence protons or whatever, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, plus 1 charge. So now we got a minus 2 and a plus 1. So this one's technically a stable system as long as we have a minus 2 charge on here and a plus 1 charge on here. And I forgot to write the question that I'm doing. I'm doing number 17. Okay? So that's one system. Let's draw the other type of system. We'll put 2 lone pairs on this nitrogen. I guess I should draw them bigger. Right? 2 lone pairs on here, which makes this thing 5 minus 6, negative 1. So this has a negative charge on it now. Carbon's still neutral, and sulfur would have this many electrons, right? Because we want it to have a full octet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In this case, because it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 single electrons from lone pairs and 5, 6 total, this one is neutral. So then we overall have a minus 1 system. So the question then is, which one of these is correct? And it's this bottom one here, because we have less total charge separation. We want to produce systems where we have as little charge separation as possible, because otherwise we're creating a huge electrostatic potential across our molecule. So this one's our answer. With nitrogen having a minus 1 charge, which is equal to number 2, I believe. Let me check. Yes, number 2.